Three, two, one, blast off. Here we go, my beautiful friends. So, if at first you don't succeed, try again. And that's how we roll around here. Mari Smith coming to you live from glorious sunny San Diego, bringing you a lovely two-part training series on Facebook video marketing. What's working today? What formats? How do you get more reach, engagement, results? And how do you work with the new algorithms? So, all right. How this is going to work, I'm going to share my desktop. I have prepared some visuals for you. We're going to do a live demo. And as it says in my description there, if you have not yet tried the wave.video platform, I've got a special little discount for you there. All right, friends. So come on in. As I mentioned last night, I was going to be doing this training for you. Like that. Show my slides. Come on, behave. There it goes. Now then, I've got Mari's video on top of Mari. The cool thing with this nifty little app, I can put myself right there if I want to. Part one of two. Number one recommendation when you're using video for Facebook is to optimize for mobile. So we're going to go into that in today's session. What does that mean and how can you do that simply, easily, without taking up a lot of your time and resources? Okay, friends? And good. I can put myself over there and dive in. So video content for mobile. Actually, let me take the overlay off now. Come on, Mari. I really need a producer. There we go. Beautiful. So what is working on mobile? Like I say, so absolutely Facebook Live. Remember when they made the notifications? Well, Zuck brought out on the 11th, the big sweeping change to the algorithms, and then another change on the 18th. Look at my calendar over there. Or 19th, actually, I think it was, about the news, the authentic news. But before that, on January 11th, Facebook made a big announcement about the newsfeed change, seeing more posts from friends and family. And in that update, both Mark Zuckerberg and Adam Mosseri, the head of Facebook newsfeed, did say for sure that live gets 6 times the engagement than regular video. So you definitely want to continue doing live, and that includes for mobile. When you're going through your newsfeed or you get a notification, if you've signed up for notifications, certainly when you're in desktop, I don't know about you, but when I see that little pop-up go by for the live notification, you know, I just saw, if you have a long description now, I never used to do that, but now a longer description, I tend to put a little bit more verbiage in my Facebook Live descriptions. And I saw the whole, you know, the whole thing pops up on desktop over there. So definitely wanting to do more Facebook Lives, but there's more to it than that. So let's keep going here. 6 times engagement, like I say, I recommend longer. We were having a chat last night on my page, and some of my folks here were asking, well, Mari, how long is longer? And I'm going to recommend ideally a minimum, if you can, of 20 minutes. And if you can go longer, you know, 60 to 90 minutes, the max Facebook allows you to do is 4 hours. 4 hours for most people, although I do know they have capability to do 8 hours. And then if you do the continuous broadcast where it doesn't actually save the video, you've ever seen those like the Eagle cams and baby giraffe cams, they just stream constantly and there's no limit because they're just streaming constantly. But interestingly enough, and I was sharing this on my Facebook Live last night when I went live last week for a longer period of time, about almost 90 minutes, and that got over 100,000 reach. And so I am noticing for sure my longer lives are getting a bit more reach. And then for sure, episodic. Facebook is actually rewarding regular content. Now, if you can go live or you can schedule a video and publish it at the same time, the same week, let's say, you know, Tuesdays at 10 or, you know, Thursdays at 2, whatever your show time is, then Facebook will begin to reward you with more reach and engagement. The key, what Facebook is looking for, is repeat viewership. So at the moment, if it's not episodic, and I've said this on many, many of my lives and inside of my fast Facebook training program that I'm leading right now, is that I'm getting ready to launch my own shows. So there, it's really exciting. You'll see. So we've got, you know, 3 different times, 3 different days each week, and that'll be my shows. But at the moment, Facebook will still reward you even if you do not have what's called appointment television. Appointment television is like this episode where you go live, you're publishing your videos same time of day each week and time of day. What they're looking for is repeat viewership. Okay, so with myself, that people coming, people have notifications turned on, if they, you know, as soon as you go live, if someone's got notifications and then they can see, you know, when Facebook knows, you know, how quickly the person starts to watch the video from the moment they see the live notification. So all of those are factors. And we've been having some conversations in some of my communities. Does it make a difference whether you use Facebook's new creator app or you use Facebook's native, because you can use native obviously on the Facebook app or in the Pages Manager app if you wanted to on mobile or directly on desktop or a variety of third-party apps. Today I'm using Ecamm. Ecamm is up for a Mac. Wonderful software that broadcasts through Macs. But the creator app, because it's mobile, I think that we're going to see more Facebook favoring content created by the creator app. And then what this program today, this training is all about, is really about creating those videos. And you want to test your length. So on that note, video ads for mobile. If you're only doing ads, because I want to make a key distinction and a slide coming up, you'll see what I mean by that. Let me make my camera just a smidge bigger because we've got plenty of room in my slides. That's the nifty cool thing we can do with this app. And I think I can go ahead and see your comments over here too. Yeah, fantastic. Hi, Mike Blue and Michelle. Uh-huh. Shelly. Hi, Daniel. Good to see you here. And Kim, Marie, wonderful. Good. So the key for a video ad, now then, a key distinction, as I say, coming up in a slide in a moment, is there's ads where you go into Ads Manager and you create a new piece of content and it only shows in the newsfeed to your target audience. That's what most people call an ad. And it used to be called a dark post or an unpublished post. And many people still refer to it as that. And then you have, one second, you have the content that's on your wall anyway. So a video that you've published on your wall that includes your lives once they've finished. Facebook calls those VOD, video on demand. I also, at times, I will lump those into the same conversation about ads. Okay, so I want to make sure that we're clear on this. You'll see in the next couple slides, it'll become even more clear. So let's say you're only doing an ad. This is for content that you're paying to be seen to your target audience in the news feed, but not on your wall necessarily. You want to make those a roughly 6 to 15 seconds. Why? Because that is the length that Facebook will pop in as an ad break that will put into other videos, including some lives. Actually, I don't know if they're still doing lives. They tested live last year and they tweaked it a little bit toward the end of last year. I got some resources coming up in a moment. I got all kinds of tabs open to share with you guys and gals. So if you're only doing an ad, a short ad, a video ad for the ad breaks. And as this predominantly, this whole lesson today is about, it's creating in a format that's native to mobile. Why? Because 84.5 or 6, I believe it is now. So let's just call it 85% of Facebook's users, 2.07 billion around the world, access the platform predominantly through their mobile devices. So even though people like myself and you guys all out there, maybe you spend a lot of time in your office looking at your desktop, either a laptop screen this big or like me, and I'm going to go beyond the camera angle here, as I have a very large screen and I'm used to looking at Facebook at a very large screen. However, many, many times a day, I also am looking at Facebook on my small screen, my mobile device. Right? And with that, I actually believe I have it right here. I can pull it up for you just for the heck of it. See that? So, and I'm going to show you some things today on my phone. You know, so then I look at video all the time. There's Owen. Hi, Owen. And so I'm going to look at what's, why is it every time I'm live, Mark Zuckerberg makes a big post? We have to pause everything. Our next update on 2018 focus, make sure Facebook isn't just fun, but also good for your well-being and for society. Hooray! We'll make a series of updates to show more high-quality, trusted news. Okay, that's great. I see more local news, so local. Okay, starting today, we're going to show more stories. This is breaking news 14 minutes ago from Zuck. More stories from news sources in your local town or city, whether you like it or not. Oh, I inserted that. If you follow a local publisher, if someone shares a local story, it may show up higher in newsfeed. We're starting this first in the US. Our goal is to expand to more countries. Local news helps build community, both on and offline. It's an important part of making sure the time well spent on Facebook is valuable. Now then, I love it when Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg uses the keyword build community, because remember, he's really doing a lot of focus on groups as well. And there's great ways you can use videos inside of groups and building your community inside of groups. So anyway, we'll come back to that and look at it a little bit later, but that's interesting. Oh, over 500 shares in 17 minutes. Hey, Zuck. So anyway, I go through here and I will frequently look at, you know, okay, so there is an image ad, but I scroll through and I look for videos. I'm always looking for video ads. Here's my friend Larry. Hiya. Oh, look, thanks for showing me, Facebook, that I'm live now. So I'll come back to that later. But my point is, make sure if you, like me, use your desktop a lot, make sure that you intersperse your Facebook experience with plenty of mobile as well. On average, Facebook users access 14 times a day, okay? Might even have gone up for almost an hour a day, 50, something like 50 minutes a day, and then another half hour on messaging apps. And if you're anything like me, it might be 14 times an hour. too funny. So what are those formats native to mobile? I have some examples for you. Might even do some live. Again, we'll go back to my phone and look at some lives as well. Someone says he couldn't see my phone screen, but hopefully he could. Oh, I see, because my video. Oh, I see. Yeah, I see what I did. Silly Billy me. Okay, got it. Let me do that again. I was messing you up. I got to put that down there like that. My bad. I wasn't looking at your comments. See, you guys are so awesome. You always give me real-time feedback, so I need to pay attention. Do-do-do. Yeah, I see what I did wrong. That's better. Like that? Yeah. My bad. Ha ha ha. That's a pretty backdrop today. It changes. It changes. Yeah. So this is what I was doing. Now you can see it better, right? And I opened this up and what we saw right away, we saw Zuck. Some of you saw a portion of that, but we'll just go and just for the heck of it, just to make sure that we're doing this right. Right a minute ago when I had this pulled up. Yeah. We were reading this update right here from Zuck about local news. All righty. So you can go and check that out later. Not right now. Don't jump off right now. And like I say, we'll come back to my phone, but I promise I won't put my video on top of it. Okay, let me minimize that, go back to my slides. So what is native to mobile? Oh, that is so interesting. Being a little ornery today. It's probably just me. There it goes. I'm confusing Ecamm. It's like, Mari, make up your mind. What visual do you want to show? Square. So there's been many studies done out there by a variety of different companies, and Square is, remember that Instagram really is kind of the birth of Square, if you will, right? We all associate Square photos and Square videos with Instagram, and we kind of got used to it there, and it's good. And one of the reasons is because it takes up more space. It's wider, it's taller, okay? 1080 by 1080. So Square performs better on Instagram and Facebook, on mobile, and I believe even desktop, but definitely on mobile. You can also look at portrait. So portrait, or sometimes referred to as mobile, is a 2:3 ratio, 1080 by 1280. Then you've got your stories ratio, which is 9:16. And that's just your phone this away, right? This is 16:9, but that is 9:16. 1920 by 1080. Now, I don't profess to be an expert when it comes to all these tech specs. I know just enough to be dangerous. Canvas. I found some great resources for you guys and gals that I want to share with you as we progress through here. I thought this was terrific. This one right here, a shout out to Michael Murphy. I found this on Medium. Now, this is specifically for Instagram, but it also goes into stories. And he has all the different formats and ratios. So anybody wanting to really kind of dig into the tech specs, I think you'll really like this. I'm going to just pop it on this video for you. All right, friends. Well, it takes a while to load, right? Spinning, spinning, spinning. Come on, come on. Boom, boom, boom. Here we go. So this is a super helpful resource for Instagram video specs. Smiley face. And indeed, Sally is asking about my Scottish accent. If this is the first time you're hearing me, my friends, I am Canadian born, first 12 years in Canada, 20 years in Scotland, Edinburgh, Scotland, where my mother and father are originally from, both born in Scotland, but I was born in Canada and my sisters. And then the last 19 years in San Diego, California. If you're good at math, I just gave my age away. Damn it. I don't mind. I don't have any issues around that. So very good. So that's really good to know. The specs, and I know it can be confusing because you're saying, well, square, well, but how do I make square? How do I shoot in square? How do I create square videos? How do I edit and format? How do I get other assets into my videos? And that's what I'm here to share with you here today, my friends, brought to you in partnership with my good friends over at wave.video. And if you haven't seen their platform yet, I want you to see it today because I think you're really going to enjoy some of the things you can do with it. I've demoed it in the past, but they're always adding some cool new features. So I'm going to do a couple more slides and then we'll do a live demo on Wave. And then I've got some examples for you too. So coming in part two, so tomorrow, this time, this station, same time, same station, I'm going to talk about getting more reach, engagement, and results, clicks, leads, sales, how to do all that with your video. Okay, today is mostly about formatting for mobile. But I want to make this key distinction. This is a slide I was mentioning earlier where, not to confuse, when I say ads, people say, well, ads, what does that mean? Boosted post? Does that mean that it's a dark post? Is it on the wall, not on the wall? So first of all, you want to, for me, the way I refer to it is any piece of content on Facebook or Instagram that you have paid. You have paid Facebook or Instagram to elevate the reach, whether it's the boost button for a piece of content on your wall, or you're going into Ads Manager or Power Editor for you power peeps, and you're creating an ad that is only an ad and not on your wall. To me, they're all ads because you've paid for them. They're sponsored posts, sponsored stories. So you want to be thinking about what kinds of great video content can you test on your wall, if you will. Creating some great video content that just goes on your wall, see what kind of organic reach you get, and then you can go ahead and occasionally use the boost button, maybe about 10% of the time. I've mentioned that many times. This is directly from Facebook. Roughly 10% of your entire Facebook and Instagram ad budget use on the boost button. The other 90% you use inside of Ads Manager. Okie dokie. So that is a part of your promoting. I want to give a shout out to my good friend, Larry Kim. Larry Kim's the founder of WordStream and also a brand new company called Mobile Monkey. Lovely bot company, Mobile Monkey. And Larry's just a genius. I love Larry. And he has this whole concept we've spoken about before. Some of you heard it, but about unicorns versus donkeys. And the unicorn, by the way, is Scotland's national animal. We love that. But the unicorn in Larry's distinction is content, posts, videos, articles, content that you put out there that gets 10 times or more the reach, engagement, results, clicks, views. So those are the ones that you're looking to find in your wall post content. That includes your live broadcasts. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, sometimes I'm finding when I go live longer, I'm getting much more reach, and includes your longer videos. And then just as an ad inside Ads Manager, test those shorter videos. That's not to say you couldn't also test them on your wall. You might do a 6 to 15 second video, post it on your wall, get some organic traction, get that social proof so you've got the reactions, shares, saves, views, comments. Then you turn that into an ad. And that you can do inside of Ads Manager because you want to be able to do tests, split tests, and do different placements and different audiences. Okay, my friends? So I wanted to make that real clear. We'll come back to this point and go much deeper in tomorrow's segment. And as I say, test longer. Don't just think, oh my God, I can only do 6 to 15 seconds because that's the length for a video ad break, a mid-roll or a pre-roll. That's great. And Facebook's definitely showing more ads now inside of the Watch platform. Actually, I said I would have some resources. Hi, Ian Anderson Gray. It's good to see you here. Oh, I just love your questions. I know. I want to answer lots of your questions. Ian Anderson Gray, I'm going to answer that right now because I see his question right here. And in fact, I got to do something super cool with our eCam. We're going to do this and put Ian's name up in lights. Ian is a great friend and a wonderful singer and a wonderful live video teacher. I definitely recommend promoting your live videos afterwards. In conjunction of what I just said, like with Larry Kim and how you're looking for those unicorn posts and getting some great organic traction, leave it for, you know, several days. That's what I might do with mine, is like several days to get every bit of first organic reach as I can, then putting some budget in there and getting even more reach. Okay, great way to do it. And I thought I saw one more. Oh yeah, I want to just address this one for Sarah right now. Why is it ratio 10-90 boosted for ads? Okay, great question, Sarah. Directly from Facebook, the boost button is seen by the ad algorithms as a lightweight ad interface. And the ad algorithms know that you are more of a novice advertiser if you only use the boost button, and especially if you only use it and you're only boosting to your fans. You're more advanced if you use the boost button and you're using custom audiences, saved audiences that you've made already, or you've created a new one. And maybe if you have the pixel installed, well, definitely if you have the pixel installed and you're using saved or custom audiences, you can still use the boost button. Then it'll go, oh, okay, we've got a slightly more advanced advertiser. But as soon as you start using Ads Manager and you are selecting, you know, traffic or leads or conversion, you have the pixel installed, you're even tracking conversions, and you are doing some split testing and you're using custom audiences, lookalike audiences, saved audiences, all of that tells the ad algorithms that you are a more sophisticated advertiser, right? And you will get more bang for your buck, if you will. Okay, so ad breaks. Yeah, let's come back to that. I want to get into the Wave demo because we've got some really cool things to show you, my friends. This is what I was referring to. But this just came December last year about the ad breaks. I think that's what I was talking about. Yeah, about but longer, and then they had some news over here that Facebook eliminates ad breaks on short videos, but then they're expanding the ads in the Watch tab. That's what it was. The subject I was on was about whether to make these ads, you know, 6 to 15 seconds for your ad breaks. That's good, but then you also keep it in mind, Facebook's doubling the 90 second limit, so a 3 minute requirement. So videos have to be 3 minutes minimum, and an ad will not be shown until the 1 minute mark. Facebook doubling the 90s. Oh no, those ads won't be appearing in those super short videos anymore. The change also puts the first ad further into the video at 1 minute. That's exactly what I thought. So 3 minutes. So a video that's 3 minutes or more, 1 minute in, an ad break can be shown. That's the point I'm making. But those ad breaks are short. If you're doing longer video ads, it will not show up as an ad break inside of a video. That's the point I'm trying to articulate. Okay, friends. So wave.video live demos. I love doing this. And I want to do some real-time live, cool live ads or videos here with y'all. So we're going to look at a variety of formats: square, portrait, otherwise known as portrait or mobile, stories, making an intro or outro for your creator app. And then plus, don't forget, you have got landscape, and there's, it's not like you never want to do landscape anymore. You can still do landscape and testing it and see how it performs against your square videos. And then you can even make Facebook cover videos. That is what I really love about Wave. It's the only app that I know of, the only video creation tool that I know of that allows you to do basically six in one formats. So let me do this. I'm going to do one of those cooking show demos where I'm like, here's one I created already. let me go like that and like this and like that. Okay. So I am inside, and let me make my video just a teeny bit smaller, just so that, make sure I'm not covering anything up. I'm going to make myself wee Mari. There's wee Mari down there. So I'm going to show you one that's completed, but then we'll go right from scratch. We're going to create one from scratch. So if you've never seen Wave Video app before, the cool thing is one of the first things that you'll notice is these tabs at the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So six different formats simultaneously, plus, I should have made this clear in the description. I'll go back later and put it in. The cool thing about Wave.video is you get access to 2.5 million royalty-free licensed assets. That's photos and videos. So last week, I think it was last week, might have been week before last, Fiji Simo, she's the head of video at Facebook. And Fiji announced on her profile that Facebook was testing this watch parties feature. And watch parties is a way for Facebook group admins and moderators to take a public video and play it inside of a group and all the group members together watching it. Okay, so now this, I'm going to show you how my brain works. Well, a part of it. You don't want to know everything about how my brain works. But I saw that announcement. I'm like, anything to do with video, I want to make a video post. So I come to Wave and I'm like, I can't even remember what I searched for. What would be the name of that? I guess replace, yeah, no, I don't think so. I don't remember the name of that video. I'm trying to think if I can see anywhere, but watching videos, I think, you know, and so if I go to play this, let me mute the volume because there's music on that. So it's basically, you see some friends, they're eating the popcorn. It kind of pans around a little bit. It might be a little jumpy on your screen, but they're sitting around and then a little dog comes along. And then I put Facebook's own screenshot. This is Facebook's own screenshot. And that's a still image. Okay. So I just search for a clip, this video clip, and then I add the text overlay. You see my logo down here. I'm on standard right now. I probably did the square. Yeah, I did the square format. And you can see what I've also been able to do on my watermark is I've added my logo. And then the cool thing is with the logo is that I can move that around and I can make it bigger or smaller. And then it goes on throughout the whole video. Okay. So you'll notice with almost all my videos, created videos, not necessarily the lives, although the lives you can do a lower third, on most of the platforms. So you've got your watermark and then you can easily like drag and drop these blocks. You know, I could start with that. I can put different transitions in. I often just put no transition in because I just want it to go, you know, as quickly through the content. You can put calls to action in. You can trim this video. I go over here and I can go trim. You can see it's quite a long video in this case. It's 12 and a half seconds. Oh, the actual video itself is longer. And then you can even adjust it. Like I can move this if I want more of that popcorn in. Right. And then also with the text, you can put different text blocks in. So that is, so let's say I produce that. I was like, okay, I'm happy with it. I've added some music and then I go to publish it and I just go ahead and I download it. I usually do 1080. You can download in 1080 if you want, make it nice and high resolution. You can do 720 if you want. 720 is just fine for Facebook, but I like to have it as high res as possible. And then I'm like, okay, so let's say I've exported that and it's doing really well. And then I'm like, gosh, you know, I think I want to try it in a different format. Let's just say in this example, it was doing really well and I want to make it a cover. I want to put it up on my cover. So the first thing you see, as soon as I click cover, it just needs a little bit of formatting. I want to make sure that that text isn't too big. So I'm just going to reduce that down. Maybe I just choose a lighter font. You know, I have to make sure it's legible. You've got all your different fonts here. And I'll show you in a second. The cool thing with these fonts is that you can preset them, the fonts, the colors, the branding. And wave.video is super cool for agencies because you can have numerous different brands. I'll show you that in a second here. So I don't want the text to be too big, but let's say I just, you know, playing around with it over here and you can break it up. You can put another, you know, subheading right here. Want that to be smaller. You can play around with the, there you go, I'm making it the orange. This is cool. And then you can tweak the effects of how the text comes in. Really nice and easy. And then do your different text blocks. Now also, I like to have something happening immediately in the first 3 seconds for sure, right? Because that is the amount of time that is that autoplay and counts as a view, and you want something to be happening very quickly in your videos. So you keep going like that and you're making your different text blocks. I told you about the music and the logo, the branding. Actually, the watermark on my square video was on the bottom left. But see how I have it up here. I'm just going to click on watermark now, and I can move my watermark wherever I want. Actually, top right's pretty good for doing a Facebook cover video. And then I mentioned about branding. I want to show you that. If I go up here and I've got all these different brands, it's going to go manage brands. Of a variety of brands, I could go add a new brand, or let's just say I want to do something with my own brand here. So fonts, I go into font. There's 300 fonts. I know that Wave is even adding more. So you get to preset all these different wonderful fonts, and bold and italic and regular, whatever you want. You choose your fonts, all kinds of colors, different color schemes. It gives you a preview of what they look like. So those are just so easy. That means you don't ever have to think about it every time you come back and you're making a video specific to one brand. Okay, so that's a super cool feature. All right, so let's start from scratch. I'm gonna go like this. Also, I'll show you with your own project. You see all my different videos. Let's say I have a video that did really well. This is actually my cover video up here. This is promoting my fast Facebook program. And let's say I wanna make a different version of that. I would just go to the three dots and I just go duplicate. So I'm just going to duplicate that video and make a different version of it. That's super easy. But let's start from absolute scratch. I'm going to go create project. Here it comes. I'm going to show you how easy it is to search the library. Uh-oh, running slow, probably because I'm doing all kinds of things in my background here. Broadcasting, we just hit refresh. Not too much can't be fixed with a refresh. On any app. Beautiful. Oh, okay. Come on, you behave. No, well, if that doesn't want to play nice right now, then we'll just go ahead and take one of my like I say, the cooking show, right? Never fails. You're in the middle of a demo. Come on. All right, here it's gonna play nice now. Okay, so with that, let me do this. So just for fun, let me go and bring up my comments because I want to do a real time and see if someone here wants to give me an example. Challenge me. What topic would you like me to make a video on? Just throw one out. A double dog dare you to challenge me. It's coming up now. It's playing nice. Just throw out a subject. What do you want me to make a video about? I'm going to do a real-time demo. And then we've got some examples. Bella says she has a book coming out. Ha ha ha. Shelly says motorcycles. Okay. All right. Done. Shelly, we'll make a video about motorcycles. Let's do that. Okay, so I went here and I just said new, let me just pop my comments off so that, well, actually I put my comments down there. So When you go to start a new video, we're not seeing now my tabs across the top. Actually, let me reduce that and I'll take that one out so it's just not too many things happening in the background. I'll go like that, because we've got a lot of things. That's fine. So super duper easy. As you see, if you can see that, it's very small, but it says 2.5 million royalty-free video clips, photos, and images. Love that. Rugs, you guys are making some great. Okay, so motorcycle. It's a little slow. There it goes. So I'm just going to do this. I just put motorcycle in, and I might start with a photo or I might start with a video. But the cool thing is that all I do is I type my keyword or keywords, key phrase, hit enter. And I think I'm really pushing my computer to the limit right now because of running Ecamm and I'm running Wave and I've got things in the background. So, but usually I find it lightning fast. Oh, farmers markets. You guys are giving me some great, great topics. Rugs, that's funny. So, oh yeah, I'm already seeing some cool ones in here. The nice thing about this, the assets that you find, they don't look like kind of like too, like inauthentic is probably the best word I can use. They look like they could be genuinely stock assets that you've created yourself just for fun. Now, yeah, so I can see that's playing away. That looks like fun. That looks like fun just for the heck of it. That one. So I might go like that. Add. You can preview. You can hover over each of these little video clips and go and just go add like that here. Oh, I love that. Hey, Shelly, it says Rebel Motorcyclist. That's the clip we're going to use. Rebel Motorcyclist. So before we do anything there, it's going to give me my branded color. So I think I'm going to do my blue like this, and I'm going to make it a bit smaller. I want it more like that, a little smaller. And then I can place the positioning. You've got these 9 different positions. I think I want it down there at the bottom, and I'm going to say, let's see what a wild message might be. Go for a wild drive today. Test drive. Let's say I'm promoting motorcycles. That's funny, Shelley. And you want to play with the font till you get the right one that you want, the right looking feel. And it's legible. Keeping in mind, now I'm looking at a large screen. Now you might be watching this on mobile, but I'm looking at a large screen. But I remember I'm wanting this to be very good in mobile. Now, right now, remember I'm landscape, but I want to go, let's do square. We're going to do a square video. Nice. Let's say I wanted to move the video over a little bit. I'm going to just pick her up and, you know, make sure that I can see the full motorbike in there. And however long is 28 seconds long. So I can go ahead and put another text block right here. Visit us today. And then, you know, whatever the, you know, awesomebikes.com. I've got butterfingers today. Oh, I totally do. My dyslexia is acting up clearly. Yeah. And then I'm going to make that a little smaller, and I'm going to just do a different brand like that. Just make it prettier. Very nice. I can hear my hard drive going. It's very interesting because this is a powerful computer. I don't know if awesomebike.com exists. So, and I might add some more assets. Now I can either go into the video and do that trim like I just showed you a minute ago. Or even easier, I could just grab the end of it right here, click and drag it, whoopsies, to wherever I want there. And I could put a call to action button right there. They've got sign up now or something like that. You know, put your logo right there, so on. And I might put one more, maybe we add another clip or an image right here. And now I'm going to, instead of a video, let me see what they have for photos and images in the stock collection. Take a second just to drop in. Here it comes. Come along. If you just joined us, we're doing a live demo of Wave.video. It's an awesome video creation tool where you can make six formats in one. And we're talking specifically in today's training about optimizing for mobile, making great, great videos that stand out on mobile, one of which is a square. Square, then portrait or mobile, stories format. You can also make intros and outros for your creator app. Should put their app. Landscape Facebook cover video. Let's see if this is playing nice. Oh, for some reason, it's just not playing nice today. Not to worry. Let me go back to my edit. Just pretend we've got another thing in there. What I would do is you probably add your watermark. Go grab some music. They have some wonderful choices of music in here. 300,000 royalty-free audio clips. I always find it so easy to find music. Now, even though, my friends, I don't know if you all know this, but 80% of video ads, oh, you can see the birds feeding out there in my window. Squirrel. 80% of video ads are watched with sound off. So you must either add lower thirds and or captions if they're speaking, or even easier is just do something where the words are on the screen and the background is just music. So there's nothing at stake. If someone turns the audio on or off, it's just to enhance the enjoyment with some music. I like to do that. You'll see a lot of my videos that I make on my page are that format, just with the words coming across, video clips, images, and then the music is, you know, kind of optional. So you'd add the music, and then the nice thing is you can really preview it super quick. If I go back here, like I can just literally play this, and it might be a little jumpy. Oh no, that's nice. Go for a wild test drive today. Oh, how fun is that? Visit us today, awesomebike.com. Sign up now. I just left that call to action. Coolio, there you go. There you have it. So there's my my little video ad. Oopsies. How long is that? 8.5 seconds. Perfect. Perfect. So that would be ideal for one of those 6 to 15 second video ads to pop into an ad break. Let's say, as I say, you probably just need to tweak it around with the different text, the size, the image, the placement. We did square, maybe one mobile. That looks pretty good to me. Facebook cover, play around with that. You know, probably reduce the font size a little bit. Standard 4x3. I don't use this one much at all. I tend to use either square or the Facebook cover. Now then, Instagram story. This is kind of darn cool, eh? How cool is this to make these for your Instagram stories? Just have that play. And that video does really nicely because even though, you know, it's obviously it's a wide video, but just that portion in the middle is perfect for an ad like that. How cool is that? Love it. So let's say I wanted to do that as my intro for the Creator app. And let's take a peek at that. What you do is you go into settings on your page and then videos. Settings and videos. Hopefully you can see this. I'll zoom in just a teeny bit for you. And then right under Live Creator Kit, edit. For here, this is just images. You can use the upload art button. Or this is for a frame. Excuse me. That's for a frame that you want to have some PNG. So the transparent background, you might have a little frame or a little call to action or your name or your brand. And this is for using the Creator app. But if you hit next, here's where you're going to go ahead and have your intro video. Okay, no longer than 180 seconds. They recommend under 90. And you can see that I previously uploaded one and just said going live 3, 2, 1. And actually, I had used the Creator app the other week there and I actually clean forgot that I had loaded that up. And I'm like, I hit go live and I'm like, wait, what's that video? Oh, yeah, duh. I had loaded one up. And then the same with the outro. Right? So you just would do whatever you want to do here, your little outro, export it, download it, and upload it right here as an MP4. They recommend under 30 seconds for doing your outro. And then you've also got your live stickers. Now, how that works is it was going to stay there until you change it. And then each time you go live on the Creator app, you'll have that wonderful benefit of the intro and the outro video. It's really cool to create those inside of Wave. Now, let me do this. I'm going to show you some other examples, some live examples, and we'll do some Q&A. I'm going to go back to my slides because I save ads all the time. I save video ads all the time. Let me also do this. One second, my friends. Yeah, my hard drive's slowed down a bit. It's not giving me quite so much grief. Good deal. Thanks for being here, friends. If you just joined us, Mari Smith here doing a live training on using the Wave.video app. And we're showing today the importance of optimizing for mobile. And tomorrow we'll show you how to optimize for maximum reach and engagement results and all kinds of good things like that. Okay. Oh, nice. Very nice. Good. That's what I want to show you. So before my examples, I wanted to show you some of my own examples on my page. See, there's the popcorn one. This is the one I was talking to you about. And that was just the other week, whenever that was, 17th. And that's the video. Now then, the cool thing is, when you make a short video to go with a post, see how I have, watch this as part of the strategy. We'll go into this a little bit more tomorrow. You see how the video is 19 seconds. And then what I also did is kind of longish. So by the time people read that, and you know, by the way, caveat, Facebook studies, BuzzSumo, Buffer, so many studies out there always say, write short copy, short descriptions get more video reach. Typically, traditionally, they do for most pages, quite frankly. I just have always, historically, since 2008, I've written long narratives. And my brain kind of just, you know, likes to do that. And people have gotten used to that. But my point I'm making is because that's a short video, you can see 27,000 views. That's all organic. I didn't even put budget behind that one, 137 shares. So because I'm getting more reach and visibility, because I've done a video, and granted, this one is not square. I did do a landscape. I just thought that the view of watching that particular video clip, the friends watching a video, actually, it's funny because it's actually a projector. If you can see that, it's a projector and a screen. But it did really well. And now I can go into Ads Manager, and I can create a custom audience of people that have watched that video. Now I might do, because it's 19 seconds, a view is 3 seconds, but I might do a custom audience of 50%. That means 10 roughly, or 90%, right? So they've basically watched almost all 19 seconds. That's a good one to do. So I love doing that, stuff like that. What else do I have done here? Those are mostly all lives. Okay, so let me show you a couple examples. That I'm always, as I say, I'm always saving videos on my Facebook newsfeed, especially video ads. This one, Ryan Levesque, shout out to Ryan, the Ask Method. He is really quite a brilliant marketer. I love following his stuff. And I think this is really clever when I see marketers and advertisers making a video that has some kind of like a diagram or a mind map, or even I've seen video ads. Like if I go like this, a video ad, I've seen video ads, like let's say there's tons and tons of slides here and you can't really make them out. Let's say that over on the thumbnails, and you might have one here. I don't know. Let's say I had that one there and I might zoom that up so it's a little bigger. It fills up the whole screen, but you see all these thumbnails. I don't have that many slides, but imagine it was scrolling by. Just for the heck of it, I'm going to go like this. I'm just going to throw a whole bunch in here. There. So I've seen really good video ads like this, where the person is narrating, they're talking to you, there's just one slide, they're not clicking through them. But do you see that now? Do you see? Oops, I have to point the wrong way. Over on your left hand side, that kind of, not obviously they're all the same, I just did copy and paste of a bunch the same. But I know for me, I'm like, what is that? Oh my God, that looked amazing. That was like a flowchart. That was something I want to see. So you could do a video ad like that. That's kind of cool, eh? But this example I'm giving you with Ryan's. Now then, with my saved, I'm going to go back to my saved, and here's Ryan's post. And I wanted to draw this to your attention because it is square. We're talking all about how you can make square videos in Wave.video. And this is a long, see, here's Ryan, and I'm telling you to do short, but I have seen some really great video ads, or just ads, period, that have long narratives. 153 shares. Great job. I'm going to play that video for you. See, there's no sound at all. It's 18 seconds. And he's just kind of showing you a little narration. He's got some text up at the top. He's showing you just kind of like going through this path. And then you're like, what is that? I want that. Now, let's say you didn't have something like that. You could find something like that inside of wave.video's asset library. It's not going to be, you know, identical to this. I don't mean that. I mean something similar where there's something's being demonstrated and being shown off and like that, something like a blueprint or a step-by-step process that you might want to emulate, something fun like that, just to catch people's attention. Another Square video, MOBE live events. Let me see if I can find that one. I think it's in here somewhere. Oh, here it is right here. Yeah, I didn't save it that long ago. Facebook gave you the ability to do collections, by the way. I've just started to build out my Facebook ads. I've like almost 1300 saved pieces of content, a lot of videos. Oh, that's interesting. I just made me realize, my friends, holy smokes, they did away with the types filter. Oh no, it's all there. That's where they all are. You used to have all those up at the top, right? So if I look like just all of my videos, I'm always saving videos, right? Ryan, we saw Ryan. Let's see this one. I wanted to show you. This was a good ad, I thought. It's very nice. This looks like very similar to Wave. I don't know for certain they created it in Wave, but Wave has that effect. Actually, you know what? That is just a still image. It's just a still image of a really, you know, vibrant audience shot. It's obviously a big event. And it's just, you know, the text going across and obviously well-targeted because I'm in San Diego here. And then I wanted to show you Facebook's own one because they tend to do those are mobile, not Instagram story where it takes up the whole screen, but this format, the 2x3 format. So it's a little shorter, but it's wider. And that one, that's an ad for the Creators app. Let me go to my saved items. And I think if I just do, yeah, Creators, I had already looked it up. When you share your passion, I've saved a few of Facebook's. That's a Square, right? So this is Facebook doing their own testing. So there's Facebook with the Square Creator app, and they were really pushing it when it first came out. And then there's that ad that I had the screenshot of. Okay, that's a mobile format. And those catch my eye. These ones catch my eye because they're definitely a different dimensions, right? You see them in the newsfeed, and they're very eye-catching. Okay, so optimizing for mobile. Square, Portia, I even mentioned Canvas. And then tomorrow I'm going to go into reach and engagement and results. And there is a great, great deal for my friends at Wave.video. If you want to go ahead and get the agency or pro, they're offering a wonderful 30%. And then that's the code WPX_Mari_A30. And it is in the description of this video. Any questions at all on Wave, let us know. I know the Wave team are here. They're very responsive. They're very good on social media. They're great, great customer support. As really a powerful platform. A couple more quick things I wanted to show you, and then I'll do some quick Q&A as well. What was I going to show you as well? I was going to go back to something. Oh, I know. Yeah. I showed you that. Yeah, Canvas. Just in case, this is a little more advanced, but anybody here, I'm very curious, has anybody here ever done a Canvas ad? Because Canvas, you can actually put Square and the portrait, and you can actually build other components in there. So I wanted to show you the, not that. There it is. I'll put this in the video that I'm broadcasting right now. Very helpful Canvas guide from Facebook. Okay, friends, that's a big long link, but that takes you direct to the PDF guide. And it's super helpful because it's going to show you what it is, where the entry points are, the dimensions. You can tap from Facebook or Instagram. Then you experience Canvas, dive deeper in your mobile site, Facebook collection. These are all the entry points. Amazing. I don't see that many Canvas ads, and it's a shame because they're just beautiful. They're really amazing what you can do with them, but they do take a bit more work, of course. Carousel, single video, and then you can make any of the different wave formats, particularly this format, to say the mobile or definitely square, or the story format. You can make those and drop them into your Canvas ads. Okie dokie, friends. And then here was the point about the dimensions, the supported sizes of your dimensions. All right, so let me see what questions you have. It's always good to be with you and just try to convey as much great knowledge as I can in a shortish amount of time. Jeff is saying that he does do Canvas ads. Their engagement is huge. Yeah, it's a lot more work, but it's good payoff. Thank you for saying that, Jeff. You're right, it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh, and Sandy's done some Canvas ads. Great, good to hear, Sandy. Very nice. Yeah, I know. I'm seeing you guys are asking me about the comparison between Animoto and Wave. I am a brand ambassador for numerous companies, and I love to give my audience choices. And I also like to differentiate in helping you to make the right decision for you. If you have a lot of your own assets, photos and videos, you're a photographer, you're a small business, you have a phone full of your own assets, and you like storyboards and templates that are already laid out, slideshows are already laid out, Animoto is a great choice. And you know, I love working with them as well. We went live last week. And then with Wave, if like the demo I give you today, or the two that I showed you, the one that I had on my own profile the other week, page, I mean, with the popcorn and showing the new watch party, you know, that Fiji Simo had announced, and then the thanks to Shelley, the quick motorcycle ad we did. If you either don't have that many of your own assets, or you simply find it easier to search a library of assets with the 2.5 million video clips and the images, and you want to be able to just, you know, quickly put your own videos together kind of from scratch. They don't really have storyboards, not yet. Anyway, not that I'm aware of at Wave. And then also making those different formats. You can make square videos in Animoto, but Wave has the different, you know, you can have the six and just click the tab, make it really easy. Animoto has a similar that you can do that. I knew you guys were going to ask that because I only just went live last week with Animoto, and it's okay. Here's the bottom line. Take them both for a free trial. You know, they definitely have trials. You don't have to go right in and commit. Try them out. You might find that they have a use for both. I actually use them both for different purposes. All right, friends? Hopefully that's helpful. Ha ha ha, Sandy, you love Ryan's book, eh? Yeah, the ask method. Oh, thanks. Yes, thanks, Lori. See, I know your name now because you told me last night. 19 seconds, 27,000 views. You're right. Actually, for a 19 second, but remember those views are 3 seconds. All views are 3 seconds initially. But then you can go into your ads manager and scoop up those custom audiences for, you know, people who have seen much more than that. Yeah. Oh, Leanna, my intro video. What did I do with it? Oh, let's see if I can... what is it even called? Going live in 3, 2, 1. I might be able to do that. Oh, that's funny. You know what I should do? You know what I should do, Leanna? just for fun, I should go live from my phone using the Creator app. I've never had the courage to do that yet, where I'm live on my desktop and I decide I want to also go live on my mobile. But here's my intro video right here, if you can see that. And I made this in Wave, you know? I made this in Wave. This is just, see? It's just a little 7, 8, 9 second. I made this as a demo. I think I might have some music. I have some music on that too. Yeah. It's just my signature turquoise confetti going live in 3, 2, 1, right? Just fun, right? Now, obviously, I would want to put my name or my logo or something like that, but I had made it as a demo, and then I just popped it in. I popped it into my Creator app. I don't tend to go live on the Creator app much, though. Ed, I know, Ed, you're doing some things with Creator app. You add your logo and fun banners. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, hi. And yeah, exactly. You can create story videos. Isn't that great? Because I know you, the more, you know, that I think more brands and businesses are going to want to get more into stories. And especially when Facebook really brings out more ads in stories, that is really going to be an area for using wave.video, making those Instagram stories, stitching together some really great clips of yourself or eye-catching ads inside of stories. Yeah. Oh, and Jeff, I think Daniel's here. Daniel works with wave.video. He's our CMO, and Daniel is awesome. And I saw that he'd answered your question, but yes, they do. You can do your custom uploads. Yeah, exactly. Oh, that's funny, Kathy. Yeah, I've seen some people do that. Hold a handwritten sign up saying, turn the volume up. That's funny. Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Thanks, Daniel, for being here. Yeah, and Pam, I'm just going to pop your question there. I saw Daniel had answered it, but you can. You can change the colors for the buttons. Absolutely. Anything. Any hex code. Totally, totally customizable. It's pretty cool. Yeah. Okay. So Lori, Ellen Virtual says, she says, as much as I love graphic design, I might have to add this wave of the new service to clients. Bingo. This is brilliant. What Lori just said here, because if you are a virtual assistant or an agency in particular, any size of agency where you have an opportunity to create video content for your clients, Wave is a terrific solution. That's another distinction, if you will. That's another reason that you might want to check out Wave for putting in those different custom brands, logos, overlays, watermarks, fonts, and having your different brands and being able to create a lot of beautiful video content relatively easily, very easily, really, and then, you know, sell those on to your clients. Utilize that for their social media content. It's a perfect use. Actually, a lot. I don't know the ratio right now, Daniel, but I would say a good portion of Wave.video's clients are agencies. And that was one of the first features I know when they came out almost a year ago. Or full, yeah, I think it's been a year now, isn't it? And before that, by the way, they have a tremendous background as an animation company. Animatron is an animation app. And that was one of the most asked for features, is the ability to do those custom brands, and so to be able to produce videos that look unique for different clients and different purposes. You know, and Daniel, I don't know if Daniel's answered that question for Ian. Ian has a musical background. He is as well as being a social media and video and live expert, he's a professional singer. I know people know that about you, Ian. But he's asking about your own music. I don't know the answer to that question because I'm just looking in the background here and I don't see where you would do it. But Daniel can answer that for you. Okay. Great. And Malcolm Love, I'm going to answer that question tomorrow. I really need to jump off now. I like how you spelled algorithm with the Y. That's a cool new spelling. we're going to talk about that tomorrow on tomorrow's episode. Same time, same space, noon Pacific, 3 Eastern for part 2 of my Wave video training. And let me just bring that slide up again for you. Because today was predominantly about optimizing for mobile, as it says on my screen there. And then tomorrow we're going to do optimizing your reach engagement results, including how to work with Facebook's newest algorithm changes, right? Move my video there so you can see all my contact info. Basically, Mari Smith everywhere except Instagram is with an underscore. Ha ha ha. So hop over to wave.video. You can take it for a free trial. They have a totally free trial. In fact, I think they even have a free forever plan, but you will have the watermark on it. And there's some limitations. But once you get in there, man alive, I tell you, you're just going to fall in love with it like I did about a year ago. because of that ability to do a super easy search of all their assets. Kirill is here too. Kirill is with Wave. Awesome possum. He said that you can upload your music. We're also working on advanced video controls. Oh, I know, I know. Okay. So, oh, I clean forgot to say as well. If, friends, if you are going to trafficking conversion and or social media world, I will be there and so will Wave. So will a lot of people. But let me do this right quick. So, and I'm pretty sure Daniel and Kirill and the team from Wave, they have a booth at Trafficking Conversion. I am actually going to be doing the opening keynote on day 3 of Trafficking Conversion. Super excited. My second year in a row speaking there. And we've got some great speakers, including Ryan Dice, the founder, and Perry Belcher, and Roland Frazier. These three brilliant guys here are the creators and founders of Digital Marketer. And then we've got Damon John from Shark Tank, Robert Cialdini, author of Influence, and Persuasion is his newest book, Dave Asprey, Bulletproof, Coffee, the whole Bulletproof Empire, Maury Smith, look at that, ha ha ha. Great, great lineup of folks here. You'll see a number of people you probably recognize. So traffic and conversion, anybody's going to that? Actually, I'm gonna pop a link after I'm done this video because I have a savings code for you guys. I think it's a $300 savings code. If anybody's suddenly thought to themselves, I really have to go and I don't have a ticket yet, there's still time. So wave.video will have a booth there and they're going to have a booth at Social Media Marketing World. And so I want to let you know that if you are already a Wave customer, then you can come to their booth and get something special. I can't tell you what it is yet, but they have a special gift for their customers. Okay, so I always like to help everybody best I can. And I really appreciate that. Fiona, I just saw a lovely comment there. Fiona Weisenberg, yeah, it's a new Fiona. I know a lot of Fionas. I have one of my younger sisters called Fiona, and I have several Fionas in my community, but that's a new one on me, Weisenberg. Hi, Fiona. Thanks, Mari Smith. Always tons of value from all your... I appreciate you saying that. I do my best to teach as well as share the love for all the different companies that I represent. You're the best too, Miss Kathy, you and your cute doggies. Yeah, thanks, Ed. Okay, I can't wait to come back and read more of the comments. My pleasure, Shelley, and thanks for being the winner, the winning impromptu Facebook ad creation. Motorcycles. That's too fun. Yeah, yeah. And try see Canvas ads. Now that you know how you can easily make videos using wave.video, you give Canvas ads a try. Yeah. Okay, friends, we'll see you same time tomorrow for part 2. It's been a joy to be with you. Any questions at all, let us know. And go check out wave.video. Take them for a free test drive in a motorbike. Bye for now.